a good time. Put a smile on your face, yeah. KB Cam and Elation Radio. Even brighten your day and help you through the night. Bring you good music. KB Cam and Elation Radio. And here's your host.
Hi, this is Apostle Dawn Westbrook. Join me on Shabach Saturday here at Elation Radio at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where we Shabach the Lord and declare the word of the Lord over your life for this hour. Shalom.
I'm was created for. I was created for. Whoa. I was created for. No, I believe in God. I was created for. Whoa. Bless your name.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. I love, love, love that song. It is the epitome. Amen. It is the my point of reference for everything that I do. We were created to worship him in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Did you know that, people of God? The word says in Revelation chapter 4, verse 11, you are worthy, O Lord, our God, to receive glory and honor and power. Hallelujah. Scripture says in John 1, 3, amen. Hallelujah. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We exist and were created, people of God, to worship our God, to lift up our hands, to bless his name. Hallelujah. His name is Elohim. His name is Jehovah Rapha. Glory to God. His name is Jehovah Sikkenu. Hallelujah. His name is Jehovah Makedesh. My God, today, we were created for worship. Glory to God. Well, hey, this is your host of Shabach Saturday, Apostle Dawn, also known as PD. Amen. Apostle PD Westbrook of Healing Mountains Ministries International. And that's what we do. Amen. Listen, there is a great shaking in the heavenly realms, people of God. You better recognize, glory to God, that we have been given the authority in this hour, in this time, this timing of God, my God, today, to speak and say something. Yes, say something. Amen. To Shabach, our awesome God, and encourage you, our listening audience, on today, because this day, today, when you woke up and open your eyes, and you took your first breath, when you stepped out of your bed, amen, and placed your feet on the ground without the assistance of anyone, amen, when you walked through your home today, hallelujah, when you spoke, amen, this is the day. You have mobility, amen, you are in your right mind, glory to God, hallelujah, and you are still breathing. This is the day that the Lord has created. This is the day that he has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it in the name of Jesus. That is not cliche, people of God. It is a truth, and it is a reality. So today on Shabach Saturday, we are honored to have Evangelist Jackie Anderson of Maintaining Anointing Deliverance Ministry, my God, today, out of Georgia. How are you, woman of God?
Oh, I'm just blessed. Amen. Just blessed by the Lord. Good to be here. Praise God.
Hallelujah. Well, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for being here with us on today. And thank you, everyone, for tuning in today on this very special Shabach Saturday with our featured guest, amen, the one and only, hallelujah, awesome, anointed, and appointed evangelist Jackie Anderson. Listen, glory to God. We are here today to inspire you and to move you in the realm of his glory. Amen. So, woman of God, thank you again. Hallelujah for joining us this afternoon. Please, everyone else that is not speaking, please mute your phones so that you will not interrupt the woman of God when she begins to go forth. Amen. Hallelujah. But listen, woman of God, I want you now, Glory to God. I know that there is a word in your belly.
Praise God.
Please go forth and share with our Elation family and our listening audience what the Holy Spirit has placed on your heart for his people in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you again, Apostle Westbrook, and I thank the Lord for you, and I thank God just for this opportunity. Praise God just for you to invite me, praise God, and to come on, praise God, just to share a word, praise God, with the people on today. And I do give honor to you, praise God, and I tell you, God is an awesome God. And I praise and I magnify the Lord for all that he is to me. I thank him for his goodness. I thank him for his mercy. I thank him for his grace. Praise God. And above all, I thank the Lord, praise God, just for loving me and loving you and everyone that's tuning in under the sound of my voice. And truly, there is a word from the Lord at this time. And the Lord had just been dealing with me during the past week, praise God. And the Lord just took me to 2 Thessalonians, the 2nd chapter, and the 1st verse. And the word of God reads, "Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled by spirit, word, letter, as from us, as that day of Christ is at hand." Praise God. And it says the 3rd verse, "Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come." Praise God. Listen to this. "Except there come a falling away first." Praise God. So we know we are living in the last days, and we are living in the last times. And the Lord Jesus has let us know through the word of God, through the Apostle Paul, that this day shall not come except there come a great falling away first. And the Lord said to me, he said, "Jackie," he said, "there has been such a great falling away of my people, of the people of the Lord." And he said to me, not only that, he said, "but the church and many of my people have become insensitive to me." Praise God. And that word insensitive, praise God, that's the word that the Lord has been ringing in my heart, that word insensitive. And the word insensitive simply means showing or feeling no concern for, not responsive. And the Lord said, "My people have become non-responsive to me in so many ways. They show no feeling or no concern for me." And insensitive also means heartless. And the Lord said to me, "Jackie, I cannot feel my people." Praise God. And whether we know it or not, God is real, and God is alive, and God can feel. Somebody sing a song and say, "God is not dead, but God is still alive." Praise God, and he's sitting on the throne in heaven. But we live in a day and time, the Lord said, when my people have become so insensitive to me. Praise God, I cannot feel them. Praise God. They don't love me, praise God, like they used to love me. Praise God. They don't go in to seek my face like they used to seek my face. And the word of God even tells us to seek ye the face of the Lord. Praise God. Seek ye the Lord while he is near, and call upon him while, praise God, he is present. Praise God. And seeking the face of the Lord. Praise God. We need to, praise God, stay in the presence of the Lord. And the Lord said, because, praise God, they have become so insensitive, they will not spend quality time, praise God, in the presence of me, God Almighty. And praise God, the Bible tells us in 1 Timothy, the 4th chapter and the 1st verse, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith. And the Bible said, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Many have, praise God, departed, praise God, from the true faith of God. And we have some of everything, praise God, that has come, praise God, into the church nowadays. And we live in a day and time, praise God, it's so hard to tell, glory to God, who's who, praise God, unless you have, praise God, the true spirit, that gift of discernment, working and operating in your life. He said, if it was possible in this day and in this hour, glory to God, the very elect would be deceived. There are all kinds of seducing spirits and doctrines of devils that have been let loose upon the man. Praise God. They are appearing to be, praise God, the angels of light. But it's Satan, praise God, who has taken on the disguise, praise God, of a shepherd. But inwardly, God said, full of dead men's bones and just like ravens and wolves, praise God. But God said, because of these things, praise God, the church has become, and many of my people have become insensitive to me. 1 Timothy 1 and 19, the word of God tells us, holding faith and a good conscience, which some, having put away concern in faith, have made shipwreck. And if there is a question that Jesus asks in the Bible, the question is asked in the Bible, will Jesus find faith when he returns to earth? But many faith have gone shipwrecked. Praise God. We're looking, praise God, unto gadgets and gadgets. We're looking unto some of everything, praise God, instead of believing and stretching out on faith. And I thought about it, praise God, when God told the prophet to go, praise God, and prophesy down in the valley of dry bones. Many people's faith have become just like the bones that lay down in the valley. And those bones, praise God, had lain in that valley for a long time, praise God. And before the prophet prophesied and spoke life, praise God, the bones had lain there for so long until they were rusty, musty, and dusty. And that's how so many of God's people, praise God, they have become so insensitive, praise God, concerning their faith and believing and trusting God. Their faith, praise God, has become stagnant. Their faith has become rusty, has become dusty, praise God, and their faith has become crusty, praise God. But God wants us to know in this last hour that we must stretch out on our faith. Praise God. He has given every man a certain measure of faith. And I like that word measure, Apostle Westbrook, because, you know, with that word measure, praise God, I love it, because most things that can be measured, if it can be measured, it can grow. Praise God. And so faith, praise God, can grow. But then he tells us in the word of God that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If you want your faith to grow, praise God, you got to study the word of God. You got to get that word down in your heart, plant it. Praise God. He says, search the scriptures. Study the word. Glory to God. But we've got to, praise God, apply ourselves to the word and apply the word of God to our lives. David said, thy word have I hid in my heart,
Praise God. We've got to get to the place where we can hide the word in our hearts so until the word of God will begin to speak back to us. But praise God. God said this is a time for the church, and many of my people have become insensitive. Praise God. Because, praise God, of the lack of faith. The Bible tells us in the book of Jude, the Bible tells us to earnestly, with everything within us, glory to God, to contend for the faith which was once delivered unto the saints of God. The people in the days of old, they had a faith that would not die. They had a faith that would not quit. They had the kind of faith, praise God, that will conquer the unconquerable, that would believe the unbelievable, and God produced. Praise God, the church of old was a church that was sensitive, glory to God, to the needs of God. I will say it like that. Praise God, because we don't really realize it, but we serve a God. We serve and his son Jesus. They have a need for us. They have a desire for us because we are God's mouthpiece in the land. Praise God. And God lets us know, praise God, that the Lord says to know me. Praise God, we have become so insensitive and unattached to God. Praise God, we don't know Him. Praise God, like we used to know Him, and we don't love Him. Praise God, like we used to love Him. He said in the Word of God. Praise God, in the book of Isaiah, the first chapter and the third verse. He said, "The ox knoweth its owner, and the ass its master's crib." He said, but Israel, my people, does not know. My people does not even consider. Praise God. And it's troubling to the heart of God. It's troubling to God's heart. Praise God. God wants a people that will love him. The Lord said to me, praise God, to know me, people, listen, to know God is to love God. And to be known of God is love. And even God, you know, I don't know of anyone that doesn't want to be genuinely loved. Glory to God. It makes a whole lot of difference when you're genuinely loved. Praise God. And God feels the same way. He can feel, just like we feel. The Lord can feel. But the Lord said to me, Jackie, I want somebody, Obadiah, Shandia, that's going to love me. Somebody that's not going to just love me, but I want somebody that's going to fall madly in love with me. Praise God. Head over heels in love with the Lord. Deuteronomy the 6th chapter and the 5th verse. The Bible tells us, he said, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy might, and with all thy mind. That's the kind of love. That's what you call a mad love. When you can love somebody with everything that's within you. Praise God. Everything. Praise God. He wants us to love him. Praise God. When we inhale and when we exhale. Praise God. He knows, praise God, that we love him. He wants us to love him with every, praise God, inch of our being. Praise God. He wants us to love him with our whole heart. Adorosh and the Abba, not in bits and pieces. Hallelujah. But he wants the whole heart. And it's one thing, praise God, the Lord said, I can use a part-time lover. Glory to God. Oh, bless the name of the Lord, Apostle Westbrook. The Lord said, don't come to me secondhand. I don't want a part-time lover. God said, I want all your heart. I want all your love. I want it all, or I don't want nothing.
He wants full-time lovers who are going to love him, praise God, with everything on the inside. 1 John 5:3, for this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. He said, if you love me, show me. Praise God. Don't nobody want you telling them they love you and they can't show you that they love you. You can't tell me you love me either if you're giving me black eyes, if you're giving me bruises in my face. Glory to God. But God wants, he said, if you love me, show me. Praise God. He's a show and tell God. Show me that you love me. If you love me, keep my commandments. Praise God. He said, many whom I have called and chosen have become insensitive to me. Praise God. I love, but no love in return. I'm concerned, but they're not concerned about me. Heartless and insensitive. The Bible tells us, praise God, in the word of God, that because iniquity, cold-hearted, we got a lot of icicle Christians today in the church. But he said, because iniquity shall abound. He's already spoken in the word of God that because iniquity shall abound, that the love of many shall wax cold, heartless. Glory to God. And then he said to me, the church has become insensitive because the church has lost its vision. He tells us in Proverbs 29:18 that where there is no vision, the people truly perish, blinded, no spiritual eyesight, insensitive to the things of the Lord, blinded by the things of the world, want to be like the world, too attached to the world. But he said in 1 John 2:15, he's given us the word. He said, love not the word, the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. You cannot love the world and love the Father. He said, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. Then he tells us in the word of God, 2 Corinthians 6:17, I've told you to come out from among them and separate yourself. Glory to God. He said, touch not the unclean and unclean thing. Then I will receive you. The love of the world has caused us, praise God, to become insensitive to the things of God. Then the Lord said to me, they have become dull of hearing, insensitive. They will not hear and obey me. They will not obey me. Let me tell you something. Everything in the world other than man will hear and obey God. The Lord spoke to the sea, and the sea obeyed and departed. The Lord spoke to the wind and the waves. He said, peace, be still. And the winds and the waves obeyed the voice of the Lord. The Lord spoke to the donkey to speak to Balaam, and the donkey opened its mouth and obeyed the Lord. The Lord spoke to the rooster, and he crowed after Peter denied Jesus 3 times. It's something how everything will bow and obey God except man. Praise God. Man just does not want to obey the Lord. Praise God. And I thought about a song of old that the saints of old used to sing years ago. They sang a song and it said, oh Zion, what's the matter now? Oh Zion, what's the matter now? See, this is why the church has become insensitive. You don't love like you used to love. What's the matter now? And you don't pray like you used to pray. What's the matter now? And these things have caused the church to become insensitive to the Lord. Praise God. We don't love like we used to love. We won't pray again, as I stated earlier, and seek the face of the Lord like we used to seek the face of the Lord. But I hear God saying, praise God, thus says the Lord, stand ye in the ways and and ask for the own path. Where is the good way? He said, and walk therein, and you shall find rest for your soul. Praise God. And what, praise God, is the Lord calling for? The church has become so insensitive. And I said, well, Lord, what do we need to do? Praise God. God said to me, I don't need another dead graveyard church gathering. I don't want another dead conference gathering. I don't want another dead convocation gathering. I refuse to accept another dead prayer meeting. But God said, what we need on today, we need true revival. That's what God is calling for. That's the only thing, praise God, that's going to bring man back to God. That's the only thing that's going to take the insensitivity of man, praise God, against God, out of man. So God is calling for true revival. Praise God, he's calling for true repentance. Praise God, revivals. Where the Shekinah glory of God will come into the presence, will come into the church. Praise God. And it may be even out on the street corner. It may be in the park. But God is calling for true revival. Praise God. Praise God. For the gospel will be preached as never before. Praise God. Revivals where chains are broken and fetters are broken. Revivals where the gospel is preached, the gospel of Christ is preached. Unto men, women, boys, and girls will cry out of their belly, what must I do to be saved? That is what God is calling for. He's calling for revival that will shake cities, revivals that will shake states and countries and nations. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Go back to the old path. Oh, glory to God. And then the Lord is calling for repentance. I said true repentance. We have become so insensitive, praise God, to the things of the Lord, to the gospel of Christ. He said in Acts 3:19, he tells us in the word of God, repent. Then and turn to God. This is the last days and the last hours. And God is telling men, women, boys, and girls everywhere, listen to me out there, in radio land, it's time to repent and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out, that times of refreshing may come from the Lord. Jesus said in Luke 13:3, I tell you, nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. Acts 17:30. But now God commanded all men everywhere to repent. Romans 10:13. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. But the first thing you've got to do is repent. The Bible said that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and shall believe in thine heart, that God have raised Jesus up from the dead, the Bible tells us that thou shalt. He didn't say you may be saved. He didn't say you might be saved. But he said you shall be saved. Glory to God. It's time, praise God, to repent. Praise God, and come to Jesus. Praise God, everywhere we look, all over the world, all over the nation, praise God, the signs of the second coming of Jesus is in the land everywhere. Praise God. Still dealing with the pandemic. Glory to God. If you can't see, praise God, that Jesus is on his way back. Something is seriously wrong with you. We are living, praise God, in dog days and critical hours. It's time to repent. Praise God, and he wants the church, praise our God, to become sensitive. And the only way we're going to do that, we have to go back to praying. We're going to have to go back to laying on our face and our back before the Lord. We're going to have to cry out. Praise God. Praise God. My pastor, praise God, and the pastor of Westbrook, praise God. We all just came out of the weeping, wailing women's revival. It's time to weep and to wail. And pastor Three Nights, praise God, gave us a profound word, praise God, concerning the weeping and the wailing women. But then I thought about that. I said, God, please touch the hearts of the men. Because, God, not only do we need the weeping and wailing women, but we need weeping and wailing men. Oh, God, take us back. Take us back, God. Take us back. Oh, God, we've left our first love. We must return, praise God, to Jesus. The Bible says, come boldly to the throne of grace and mercy. Oh, this is the time now, praise God, if you're not saved, this is the time to get your life in order with God. We don't know the day, the moment, the second, or the hour. I had a family member, praise God, to go in during the first phase of the pandemic, COVID-19, walked in the hospital. I mean, he didn't appear to even be that sick, but he walked in that hospital on his own 2 feet. But they had to take him out because he died. They took him out on the stretcher and took him down to the morgue. You don't know what the next minute or the next second or the next hour holds. But let me tell you something, and in my closing, let me tell you something. Death, D-E-A-T-H, death. The Bible says it is appointed unto men once to die, but after death cometh the judgment. Death. Death has an assignment. It has a number that God assigns to it of individuals to take out every year. Death has to take its quota out. And praise God, we don't know if it's coming to our address. You don't know if it's coming to your address this year. But this is the time. He said, the day you hear my voice, if the Lord is calling you, if the Lord is saying, get your life right, and you know it, anytime he can speak to a donkey, anytime the Lord can speak to the rooster, anytime the Lord can speak to the winds and the waves, and they understand it, so can you. Glory to God. God is nobody's fool. Glory to God. But this is a time. This is a time to get it together with God and get it together with the Lord now. Glory to God. And I'm going to turn it back over to you, Apostle P.D. Westbrook. Glory to God. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And amen. My God, today. Hallelujah. Listen, people of God. My God, today. We are living in the last times. This
yes.
day, amen, during this season, we who do see and have observed, amen, and can testify to you that there is a great falling away of the people of God. Many of his people, as a woman of God, have become so insensitive, my God, today. I mean, when you look, and not only the people, you know, what gets me, woman of God, is it's not just outside of the church, it's inside of the church. There is
inside.
This.
Yes.
Yes, inside of the body of Christ, there is this demonstration of insensitivity, not caring, and as the word tells us to be what? To bear one another, to be long-suffering, to have bowels
yes.
of compassion, to show mercy towards one another. Amen. Many, many of the people of God within the body of Christ and outside the body of Christ, it's like we look like the world. We have become insensitive. Amen.
Yes.
My God, today, showing and feeling no concern Amen.
Yes.
You hear the need, but you would just as well turn your head and turn your ear as if you didn't hear it. My God, today, my God, today, they do not go in, woman of God, seeking the face of God like they used to.
No,
you say we need to return to the old path. My God, today we need to stay in the presence of the Lord. Spend more time with him instead of spending time talking about your brother and sister and tearing them down. My God, today, I tell you, we are living in a day and time, amen, hallelujah, where the spirit of discernment, we need to be operating in heightened discernment. We need to be operating more so in the spirit and not in the flesh. I was just thinking about this situation that I become aware of, amen. And you know, as walking in this office, you need to be very careful what you allow yourself to hear. Glory to God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. And I became aware of this situation in the body of Christ where there is this dissension and the offense towards one another in leadership with these individuals. And the Spirit of the Lord saying, you know, that is the trick of the enemy. Because he wants to keep you in this place of opposition with one another so that you will never confront him who is the real enemy. Instead, you're fighting against one another, tearing each other down with words. Oh, my God, today. Instead of going against the enemy that you have in common. Oh, my God, the word of God tells us our fight is not against flesh and blood. When are we going to get it and stop tearing each other down? My God, today, woman of God, you've said so many powerful things. I mean, we have become so insensitive to the leading and yielding and prompting of the Holy Ghost. And that's why we don't have no power. That's why we lack faith. Amen. And you're so right about we need to stretch out on our face and cry out weak and well in the name of Jesus. My God, today, you know that my little soapbox is calling the wailing women because those women, they hear the word of the God. Hallelujah. They know how to decree and declare a certain sound in the atmosphere. And we as wailing women, we've been called to teach our daughters how to wail. But you're right, the men need to wail too. The men need to cry out too because death has climbed in through our windows and it has entered our fortress in the name of Jesus. My God, today, hallelujah, but I praise God for this word. The Spirit of the Lord has indeed spoken. People of God, you that are under the sound of our voice, if you have not heard the God in the woman of God, amen, speaking clearly, unapologetically, amen, giving us instructions and strategies, amen, how to defeat the spirit of insensitivity in the body of Christ. Study your word. Search the scriptures. Hide the word in your heart. Earnestly contend for the faith. Believe the unbelievable. Amen. Be sensitive to the needs of God and his people. Be his mouthpiece in this land. Pray evermore in the name of Jesus. And love him with all of your heart, all of your soul, all of your might, all of your mind. Oh, my God, today. Woman of God, I thank you, thank you, thank you. You have put a rubber stamp right here, a push pin right here, that we need to genuinely not be faking, not be profiling, not going through any theatrics, but genuinely fall madly in love with Yeshua, with your whole heart. Seek the old path, walk therein, and look for true revival, not us just putting up platforms saying we have a revival, but have true revival and let there be a manifestation of true repentance in this land in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And that is only going to come forth if we that say that we are called by his name.
Amen.
That we have a love that comes from a pure heart.
Yes.
A clear conscience
and
a sincere faith. And that we hear, and not only hear, but we obey him with everything that is within us in the name of Jesus, my God, today. Thank you, woman of God. Thank you, Evangelist Jackie Anderson, for your heart. Oh, for just bringing forth the word untainted and unapologetically. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. Listen, people of God. Oh, hallelujah. Do not doubt what God has released in your hearing today.
Amen.
A new thing. Amen. A new thing is being released. Amen. We are not church as usual. Amen.
Amen.
Everyone has this expectation of going back to normal. And I think I even said that the normal is that Jesus is coming.
That's
period.
It.
That's our normal.
That's it.
Jesus
that's it.
Is coming. Amen.
That's it.
And God
Amen.
Is creating a path in the midst of the chaos. And we are being shifted into a new thing, into a season where God is making all things new. And he is saying, I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. Amen. I will breathe a fresh wind on these dry bones, because revival and true repentance is coming to shake the nations and the country, because change is here, people of God. It's here.
Say that.
Hallelujah. So walk into your new now with a repentant heart. Listen, he is God. He is sovereign. He is going to do a new thing in this season, and we are at our place of victory in the name of Jesus. You know, I would be remiss, because the sign of his coming is in the land, Evangelist Anderson. It is time. And with that being said, we would be remiss without doing the most important thing right now. Please, Evangelist Anderson, for those who are listening and those who will listen on the rebroadcast, would you pray, and those who do not know Yeshua, Jesus, repeat this sinner prayer with us as the woman of God goes forth and prays in Jesus' name.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you right now. Lord, we thank you, praise God, for Apostle Westbrook. We thank you for every listener under the sound of our voice right now. And God, we want to thank you right now because, Lord, you're moving by your Spirit through the airways, God. You're moving by your Spirit. It's not by man's might nor by man's power, but God, you're moving by your Spirit. Oh, God, and we believe you, Lord, that the hearts of the people have been pierced at this time. Oh, glory to God. You say he that watereth and he that planteth, praise God, is nothing, Lord, but it's you that giveth the increase. And God, we believe you right now for the saving of the souls. And we know, God, that you said that your word would not go out void, but it's going to accomplish that which you please. And your word has not gone out void, and your word has accomplished that which you please. Now, Lord, you deal with the hearts and the minds of the people. Everybody on this line that's not saved, Lord, you turn them every which way but loose. God, we believe you for a mighty move. We expect great expectations because the harvest truly is plenteous. Oh, God, but you said the laborers are few. God, we expect to see souls saved as never before. God, we believe you for mighty and strange acts. You're getting ready to move, God, in unusual and mighty and strange ways. God, that it is even going to captivate the news media. Lord, the pandemic, praise God, has been taking the spotlight. But the Lord, praise God, you are getting ready to take the spotlight, Jesus, because of the move, hallelujah, that's getting ready to hit the nation. God, you've got people coming on the scene already, God, working and preparing themselves to obey you, God. And we believe it. We're going to see miracles. We're going to see the supernatural move of God. And God, we believe you. Oh, glory to God, where men will have to fall down and say, this is truly the God of the heavens and the earth. And now, God, everybody on the line that's not saved at this time, Lord, we want to pray, hallelujah, the sinner's prayer in the name of Jesus. Praise God, if you're on this line and you're not saved, all you got to do, praise God, is acknowledge and confess that you are a sinner. Praise God, and know that you need Jesus in your life. Knowing that you don't have him, praise God, but you know that you need him. And believe that Jesus died on the cross for your sins and repent. Hallelujah. And tell the Lord, Lord, I'm a sinner. I'm a wretch undone. And praise God, ask the Lord. Ask him, Lord, will you save me? Because the answer is, if you believe by faith and you've already repented, then by faith you are saved. Praise God. And Lord, those that you save, God, open up their understanding. Open up their understanding that they may be able to understand the will and your way for their life. Because nobody's on this line by chance. Everybody that's on this line right now is by appointment. It's by appointment. So, Lord, do a work. You do a work that only you can do. Lord, man doesn't have the power to say. We don't have the power to say. We are just messengers and carriers of the gospel. But, God, we thank you for everybody on the line that you've saved. And, Lord, you touch and heal every sick body. Every sick body, D-O-D-Y, on this line, God, go in and heal. We speak and release healing, the healing power to every organ, God, from the head to the toe. God, we speak healing, God, to the brain cells, to the heart, healing the heart. Those who've been affected by the pandemic, God, that can't smell, God, can't taste, God, we speak healing, restore, God, in the heart, in the lungs, in the kidneys, down in the small and large intestines, Lord, in the womb, in the uterus, in the colon, in the rectum, hallelujah, we speak healing, God, send healing in the bloodstream, Lord, to the cells. We bind and rebuke cancer. God, we command cancer cells. We touch and agree, me and the woman of God, that cancer cells are dried up, healed, and restored. We speak and declare miracles and the supernatural doing and working of God by faith, because by faith, all things are possible. And God, we say amen, and it is so. God, with no doubting, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. Glory to God.
Amen. Hallelujah. And you that are here that are listening to us, that is an opportunity for you to go to a Shabach. Hallelujah. Because I believe the Spirit of God has heard our cry and the prayer of the woman of God as she's gone forth. And even those who have rededicated, my God, today, hallelujah, receive it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And as the Spirit of God would say, and go and sin no more in the name of Jesus. So we thank you on today, my God, Evangelist Anderson. God bless you, woman of God. Listen, people of God, begin now to believe him in his totality of his word. From Genesis to Revelation, he can take you from where you are now to where you are to be and fulfill your purpose and your destiny, my God, today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen, everyone. Shabbat the Lord. And expect a great move of God in your lives, my God, today. There has been so many declarations and decrees made that have gone forth in the atmosphere. And I just sense, hallelujah, now his angels have been commissioned to go forth and to carry out that word. And it shall not return unto him void. We decree and declare his mighty act. Amen. We have an expectation. You are almighty God, all-knowing, all-seeing, and everywhere at once in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Abba, Father, fill this broadcast with your glory. As you take this glory, let it now permeate the homes of the listeners and those who are connected to them, Lord God, that those who are under the sound of our voices and those who are connected to them, now and later on the rebroadcast, we'll experience a great manifestation of your power, of your anointing, of your presence. Touch the life and nature of God within them. Oh, hallelujah, change, change, change is taking place now. Hallelujah. I just want to say thank you, Evangelist Jackie Anderson. Hallelujah. Thank you, listening audience, for stopping by for another Shabach Saturday. Thank you, Dr. Kenny Kim and the Elation Radio family, iHeart, Spricker Radio, YouTube, for this platform. God's people, I pray the Lord will continue to bless you, continue to enlarge your borders and territories in the name of Jesus. And again, thank you. I was going to say Dr. Jackie Anderson. Amen. I speak it prophetically. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining us this Shabbat Saturday, woman of God. Hallelujah. You bless my soul. I know that you have blessed the souls of the people. Amen. And most importantly, you have pleased our Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. All of you, please come back next Saturday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, for another Shabbat Saturday at this great station, Elation Radio, amen. And thank you, Dr. Kimmy Kim, our producer, amen, woman of great faith, for your example and your heart. And may the Lord God continue to use you, amen. Oh, I'm just going to say it. Woman of God, I think you have another, hallelujah, speaker for Elation Radio, amen, who will certainly bless the people. Amen. I'm just going to put that little promo right there. Amen. But listen, God bless you all. We bless you. We bless you. We bless you. We pray that his grace and his peace will abound in your life. Amen. Now, please, Dr. Kimmy Kim, close us out. I love you all. Shalom, everyone.
Amen.
There's a place that I wanna go, where the sun is always shining, folks are always smiling. Go a place where crying is unheard of and dying ain't even thought of. Oh, a place where there's no color of skin, you won't find no sin. Oh, a place. And I wanna get there. Yeah, I'm gonna get there one day. wanna get there. I'm gonna get there one day. Get there, and you should wanna get there.